When you select rows from a table, the database can return them in any order. But this is no good if you only want to see the three heaviest toys, or noisiest, or three cuddliest. To do this, you need an order by. When you get data from a table, the database will return them in the order it reads them off the disk. This physical order rarely changes, leading to a common beginner trap, assuming your SQL doesn't need an order by. But this is a huge mistake. To see why, let's start adding some rows to our table here. So if this is a heap table, the database can add them wherever they're spaced. This is usually at the end of the table. And if the values you're adding always increase, as is common with ID columns or insert dates, the order you insert them matches the logical order. So when you query them, they appear in the correct sequence. This is just a coincidence. To see why, let's delete the first row from the table. Now, when we insert the next row, we freed up some space at the start of the table. So this could go here. Now, when we read the values, they appear out of sequence. To avoid this, you need to add an order by to your SQL. This goes at the end of your query, listing out the columns you want to sort by. It then orders your results from smallest to largest for numbers, oldest to newest for dates, or alphabetically for strings. If you want to sort the opposite way, from largest to smallest, and so on, add the descending keyword after the column. But what about our good old friend, null? Where does this appear in our sequence? By default, this sorts after all other values, so null-valued rows appear last in your dataset. But you can control this with the nulls clause. Set this to nulls first instead, and null-valued rows will appear first in your dataset. So sorting is easy if you want to order by values that always increase or decrease. But what if you want a custom sequence? Say you want to sort your bricks here by color, but instead of alphabetically blue, green, red, you want a different order. You want green to go first, then red, then blue. To do this, you need a function which maps the colors to values which go in the correct sequence. So you can map green to 1, red to 2, and then blue to 3. Put this in your order by, and then you'll get the values in the correct sequence. This was fairly easy, but if you've got complex sorting logic, it can be tricky to check you've got the mapping correct. To do this, put the function doing the mapping in your select. This makes it easy to see whether rows have the correct value or not. But now you've got your function in two places, which can lead to maintenance problems. To overcome this, give the function an alias in the select. You can then use this alias in your order by, so the function is only in one place. Or if you're feeling really lazy, you could use positional notation. Instead of naming the column, you give it a number. This corresponds to the column's position in the select, going from top to bottom. While this is easy, it opens up your code to bugs. If you change the columns in your select, but not your order by, you can end up sorting by a different column, giving you the wrong results. Avoid this in your production SQL. As we saw at the start, often when fetching rows from a table, you just want the first few newest, cheapest, cuddliest, or whatever, not the whole table. So to do this, first you need to sort your rows, and then stop fetching when you've got however many you want. But how do you know where to stop? To do this, first you need to assign each row a number that matches your sort, then a where clause that checks that this number is less than however many rows you want. Oracle Database has an inbuilt function called rowNum that does this. For each new row you get, it increments a counter. So many people will stick this in their where clause, checking that it's less than 10, 3, or however many values it is they want. but then they're surprised when they get the wrong results. Why is this? Well, it's got the processing the wrong way round. What it's doing is fetching any three rows, then sorting them, not the other way round. To fix this, you need to use a subquery. Sort the data in here, then in the outer query, filter on rowNum. Or you could use the analytic function rowNumber. This assigns an increasing number to each row, as determined by the order by in the over clause. You can then filter on the result of this in the outer query. This works, but it's a bit clunky. Luckily, this got a lot easier in Oracle Database 12c. This added the ANSI-compliant fetch first clause. This goes after your order by and states how many rows you want to fetch. This more clearly states what you're trying to do, and you no longer need a subquery. There's one more thing you need to watch for with top-end queries, and that's when you're sorting by values that aren't unique. Say you want the first three numbers from this table by color. There are several for each color, which brings the first question. Do you want the first three rows only, or do you want all the rows for the first three different colors? If you want all the rows for the first three colors, you can't use fetch first anymore. This is because you don't know in advance exactly how many rows there's going to be. So to do this, you've got to go back to using a subquery. And instead of assigning a unique value to each row, you want to assign a unique number for each color. You can do this with dense rank instead of row number. But it's more common that you want exactly three rows, which brings a different problem. The third and fourth values here are the same color, so the results are non-deterministic. This means if you run the query many times, you could get a different answer each time you run it. This is generally a bad thing. To avoid this, you can add more columns to your order by. The database sorts from the leftmost column first, then resolves any ties using the second, and so on. So add whichever columns you need to make your sorting unique. Here, that's the value of the number. So that was a quick overview of how to sort your data and limit it to the top n rows. Many databases have their own syntax for top n queries, so if you're not using Oracle Database, ensure you check your documentation. And remember, if you want your output in a particular order, you must use an order by. Thanks for watching. What did you learn when watching this video? Let us know in the comments and subscribe for more SQL magic.